I got one more thing here, everybody. Thank you guys for hanging out. This has been the best. It's ruining other audiences. I'm just that guy who's like, Atlanta, let me do this. Atlanta's like the cool dad who's not around anymore. Atlanta bought me fireworks and let me take a sip of his beer. I feel like every person in the room is like, he's talking about me. Here's my last thing I'll leave you guys with. I've been thinking a bunch about dogs recently. Yeah. Are we familiar with dogs? If you are not, they are little furry creatures. They have four legs. They have a waggedy tail and floppity ears. And when they make sounds, they go arf arf. If what you're imagining said meow, that is a cat, you fucked up your math, friend. And I've been thinking about dogs because I ran into an ex-girlfriend of mine, and back in the day, she had three show poodles. And those should have been three furry red flags. But I kept going. And in case you don't know what a show poodle is, they're the big floppity dogs that just show that God does not have a plan. He's just like, whatever, science, let this be. And two of them were these like beautiful show-ready dogs. And one of them was half dog, half mummy. It was the oldest dog I've ever seen. It had 10 hairs across its body. It had 4 teeth. It smelled bad. Its tail was a bone. And I fucking love that dog. It was the best. I spent so much time with it. And I spent so much time with it because my girlfriend at the time's friends hated that dog as much as they hated me. And they'd be petting the two fancy dogs, and old dog on its splayed hips, ever the optimist, would just go, does anyone have any love for me? And they'd be like, no, and they'd push it away. They would reject a living thing that wanted love. And it's very sad. The reason I'm not as sad is because it was a hardwood floor, so it flew across the ground like an air hockey table. Right over to the corner where I was, and I just catch my buddy, start petting him, and just go, look, friend, we're both sitting in the corner full of things that aren't gonna be around much longer. Let's just enjoy our time together. And I feel like I learned a ton from that dog, because I love an old dog. Does anybody here have an old-ass dog? I love it. I love when people are proud. They're like, look at my old dog. Deal with my old dog. He's on 100 pills. Like, because here's the thing. Old dogs are amazing. They're so full of goddamn wisdom. And I say that not because they are, but because they have white on their faces like they've grown a beard on top of a furry face. So they look like a furry wizard that is sniffing your butt. And you're just like, is there truth back there? And there's not. They're just a dog. But what they do have is the best attitude you could possibly have in life. Because here's the thing that we all don't talk about, is that every old dog you have ever met is covered in tumors. Here's the thing. Yes, we can say, I'm still right. Every person here with an old dog just went, yes, he is correct. The Braille word for gross is written across my dog's body. And here's the thing. You know who's not having a problem about those goddamn tumors on that dog? That dog. That dog is still having a great time. He's got a lust for life. If you went over to your human friend's house and they were covered in the amount of tumors that an old dog is covered in, and you had a Subway sandwich, and you said, hey man, I couldn't possibly finish this whole Subway sandwich. Would you like half? Your tumor-covered human friend would say, hey, I am covered in tumors. And that's all I want to talk about. And that's a bummer of a hang. You have that same conversation with an old dog, and their reaction is, half a sandwich? Are you kidding me? Is this the greatest day of my life? And that's the kind of attitude I want to have as an old person. Goddamn right. Now here's the best part. Every old dog on top of that attitude knows the one part of it that doesn't have tumors. And it will saddle up to you and go, hey, there's still good dog here. So why don't you get what you want, which is to not touch tumors. I get it. I'll get what I want, which is a tummy rub. And if the offer is still on the table, maybe we split that sandwich? And then you rub him down, he's like, oh man, this is awesome. By the way, have you ever tried ecstasy before? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, you've been amazing. Thank you, Atlanta, thank you, Starbar, thank you, Rodney. Clark, ladies and gentlemen.